Where
the same
Mecca.
The same word mentioned in the Quran, though.
Where is Muhammad born?
Mecca.
In Mecca.
What was the name of the Mecca before?
How far from the Kaaba is Muhammad born?
But
not very far, it's
in Medina.
Like 7 minutes over there. Like, so, in other words, you Muslims are praying to where Muhammad was born.
No, no, that's your determinology. Yeah. Because why are you using your terminology with the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No, wait, let me finish. Yeah?
Praying towards Muhammad.
Wait. Astaghfirullah.
We don't pray to your man, bro.
Listen.
We don't pray to man.
He said the closest temple is there. Pray towards that temple there.
Which Muslim claimed that they worship Muhammad?
Okay.
Any Muslim?
Okay. We have a surah called Surah Al-Fatiha. The first part of surah, the surah says, all praise be to Allah. Now, apart to Allah, the Creator, all praise.
What is your Allah's name?
We have 99 for him. How much you got?
99.
How much you got?
Where is his mark?
How much names have you got for him?
Allah, his name is Luwadud. It's better than Allah.
Let him talk. Then we'll talk. Better be peace.
See, I just
love
got
can
off
change,
now.
But you can't cover you. Because they can't love you today, tomorrow.
We have a surah called Al Fatiha. And it says, and all praise be to Allah. In the Quran, all he ever says, all praise be to Allah. Where does it say praise be to the Kaaba?
Yeah.
Tell me, show me.
But you
show me now the Quran.
What
it says, all praise be to the Kaaba.
What direction do Muslims pray towards?
We all pray to the east because it's the same direction Allah was supposed to pray to.
What was the first Qibla? What was the first Qibla, bro?
Towards the Kaaba. Where was Muhammad born?
Where did
not
the Jews used to pray to?
From the Kaaba.
What direction was the Jews pray to?
Jerusalem.
Yeah. Did they have a point of direction to pray to?
I don't know the temple.
Is that a pointed direction of them to pray to?
Yeah,
so do they worship their temple because they pray towards it?
Yes, they have in the book. The Muslims began by praying towards the temple. Let me stop you there.
In Islam, we have four things we only abide by. We have Quran, we have Tawheed, we have the Hadith.
I forgot my phone, wallah.
Where have you got that from what I just said?
The Quran that they used to worship towards Jerusalem.
I just gave you four things only Muslims can take from. The Quran, show me the verse. Show me the verse.
Reading from the prophet.
And afterwards, you provide a tasbih on the verse explanation. Unless you have that, you cannot give your own explanation. You cannot give your own explanation.
You get
making me nervous.
The priest will ask, what has made them turn away from their Qibla? Say the east and the west are gods. He guides whom he will to the right path. Thus have we made a just community so that may testify against mankind and that your own apostle may testify against you. We decreed your former Qibla
was chosen. He was Jew, Abraham was Jew, in order that we might know the apostles' true adherence, and those who were to disown him.
It was indeed a hard test. So he said,
he said, what are you saying now?
Jerusalem. So now he says to them, you're meant to pray towards the Kaaba, towards Mecca.
Let me stop you. He's not talking to the Muslims, he's talking to the Israeli, the children of Israel. You not used to pray to there, now you have to pray over there. Do you get what I'm saying?
Why do they have to pray over there?
Because there's a new law. If you read Isaiah, he's talking about a prophecy.
Am I right?
You can, I can give you the Bible, you can show me.
I'm sorry, I'm not talking about.
Why are you lying? I can give you the Bible, you can show me.
Why are you lying?
You asked me to. It's Isaiah talking about prophecy.
42.
42.
Okay, let's stop. Let's stop.
I'll give you the Bible.
I'm not saying that. I've never said that. I haven't said that. Yeah? Okay. So the prophecy that a Gentile will come to humanity to teach with a new law, a new song he will come with, yeah? Yeah? A new law.
Okay.
Now, when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam comes, he's coming with a new law. So the old law, what you used to have when you used to face that direction and pray, it's abolished. This is not the law no more. He's come with a new law. So he said, everyone, I'm talking Jews, Christians, everyone, Gentiles, humanity, you pray to the east now.
That law, why is that?
Why is that? Let me give you an example. Yeah, let me give you an example. See, when the PlayStation 1's built, when the PlayStation 2 comes out, are you going to be messing around with the PlayStation 1 now? No, come on, bring your list.
No, wait. Does God change? That is a poor example. Does God change?
God doesn't change the image or
so is God, is God going to change the cover position and he's going to put it in Mexico? So later when we're all going to be playing towards Mexico. He said that the people, the Muhammad,
Israel, where's Israel? Where is Israel? Wait, it's not Palestine. Tell me where Israel is. It's not Palestine. Do not tell me, because who are the Canaanites? Are you telling me Jews were there before Arabs?
Canaanites were there before the Jews.
Yes. Who are the Canaanites? Who are they? Are they Arab? Are they an Arab tribe or not?
They're not descendants of Abraham. I tell you that for a fact.
They're not descendants of Ishmael.
No, they're not. Because they were there before when Abraham went there, the Canaanites were already there.
Is the Canaanites an Arab race?
Do you want me to prove it to you? When Abraham went to the land of Israel, the Canaanites were already there. So how can they be an offspring of Abraham when they already was a nation?
Listen, regardless of what I'm trying to say, it's not the Jews' land. I'm not talking about if that or that. I'm saying it's not the Jews' land, period, because the Canaanites were there before. If it was the Jewish people's land, they would be there as Israel. Yeah? So we know we're not talking about Israel over there. This place doesn't exist no more, bruv, where they used to pray to.
What I'm trying to say.
Yeah, so there's a new law. Everyone, Jews, Christians, Hindus, have to pray towards the east.
Why are we praying towards where Muhammad was born? So close.
He came to all mankind.
Why are we praying to where Muhammad was born? I don't really know that. Well, I'm not praying towards Muhammad. He's not my God.
Muhammad never said he was God. He never said he's.
He's not my God. I said I'm not praying towards Muhammad because he's not my God.
You're being very ignorant.
Am I? Why do you pray? You pray five times a day, brother. You look at the times on lockdown. And you got the direction on lockdown. Five times a day, 35 times a week, you guys are praying. And you do it systematically. Now, answer me this. Why do you pray towards the couple where Muhammad was born? Don't you know why you pray five times a day? Do you know why the direction you pray towards it? You don't even know?
You're not going to let me finish?
No, brother.
Like, you're saying things when I didn't finish, like I don't even know.
Oh, sorry. I
don't know why you are saying. Listen, you're saying why do we pray when Muhammad was born? I don't know why.
Well, I don't believe Jesus is there.
What I'm trying to say is,
how can you?
Muhammad is born in the place where the direction of worth you read. That's just Muhammad. I don't know. That's just a coincidence.
Could Muhammad be using it for you to pray towards him?
The first house of worship was way there before Muhammad. So how is he using that as an excuse?
Well, he changed it. Obviously, they were using it for paganism.
Let me finish.
No, you don't. I can't speak to you. I do not want to speak to you.
What's the one who built that?
We are in speaker's
corner. So there's no proof that the Bible you read today is official.
Listen, this is
a fact.
We do not know whether Abraham built a house. We do know Muhammad was born very close to the house.
Do you know
We do know know, Muhammad has ordered you lot to pray there 5 times a day. That's
Do we know Jesus?
No.
Do we have anything here historically?
Yes. What year is this? This is 2018. Why? Because Muhammad was born 2000 and
historically that Jesus exists.
Why is this the year 2018? Why is this the year? I'm asking you a question. Why is this the year 2018?
Why is it? Because let me tell you. Because there's a thing what calls every year the number goes up. So from 2017, you would have put it up to 2018.
If you don't even know, if you don't even know,
if you don't know, from zero, Jesus Christ is meant to be born. Everything before is called BC. Things are called BC. So before Christ and after Christ. Anadominite is after Christ. BC is before Christ. So they've used Jesus Christ as a principle. Let's be order. Yeah. Now we face it to be 2018 because Jesus was born 2018. You can say scrap it all. Yeah. We don't know what year it is and the scrap time itself. You know. But these people have based their whole absence of time on Jesus Christ. Now you're gonna tell me that he never exists?
I'm saying you don't have proof. You don't have proof. What I'm trying to say, yeah.
The concept of books. There is more books on Jesus Christ.
Let's break it down to Moses. What they are. You have all these little politics. What they are. Let's break it down to Moses. Bible and Quran. Yeah? Let's break it down to what the message for the Moses came to worship. One God alone, associated with no partners. He's the only one who can uplift your oppression, everything. This is a lie. Yeah? Cool. Okay. Now, your belief is confusing. Because you have one God. Then you have the Father, Son, and Spirit. That's because you're the individual Christian who doesn't believe it. But majorities of Christians believe it. This is why it proves your book is false. Wait, I haven't finished. It's misleading you. Let me tell you why it's misleading you. Yeah? Allah never gave you a point in time. Show me in the Bible where Allah ordered you to pray.
If I was not to talk to you,
cool. So how do you worship according to Allah, what you to worship him?
You pray to him.
How? You're praying when you were praying. He never told you when to
God
pray.
God gave us things like the Sabbath. He gave us holy days and such. Well, I keep the Sabbath.
Yeah, but that's you. No.
When you read the Bible,
worship the sun god Mithra.
When you read the Bible gives you direction how to worship God in spirit and in truth. Now, when you read the Bible, it tells you to go to church to worship God on the Sabbath. God said from the beginning, he made 6 days, he created the earth, and the seventh day is the day of rest, which he made a holy. Now,
the Muslims have changed
the holy day of the Sabbath to Friday. The Christians have changed it to Sunday. They have contradicted God and have gone against his laws and have gone against his teachings.
Do you know why that happened? Because they forsake God. Exactly. The Jews forsake God and the Christians forsake God. That's why Islam came. Allah will never leave you stranded. Allah will never leave you stranded. Why are you not keeping the Sabbath? Because a new law has come. It's called a new soul. Because in Isaiah, he said the prophet, the messenger, will come with a new song. Basically, when he comes in a new song, the new law, this is the one you have to listen to. Yes, cool.
You said a lot of dialogue. You have.
Yeah? Now, with what's going on in Islam, yeah? You're praying. Let me bring back to the pillars. The first pillar introduces Muhammad. You have to acknowledge Muhammad as a prophet of God. Secondly,
that's not the first pillar.
Shahada, yes. You have to one God and
Allah's name come first or Muhammad's name come first?
God's name does.
Yeah, so now, where does it say worship Muhammad?
I never said it says worship Muhammad, but Muhammad's name shouldn't be there, full stop.
It shouldn't be there. So hold on.
Secondly,
I am the truth, and I am the way, and I am a light. Who said that?
Jesus said that.
So what? Wait, hold on. You keep refuting yourself, bro.
Is that a law?
You keep refuting yourself.
Is that a law?
You keep doing it.
Is that a law?
You've been there all day. Is he keep refuting himself?
He would. Is that a law? No, it's not a law.
What's not a law?
I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man come up with that's a statement.
That's a law.
That's a statement. That's now, a in the second, now in the second, I go through all the five pillars and I show you that they're all about Muhammad. It's all about Muhammad. Muhammad has brainwashed you, lot. Okay then.
You can never
okay,
tell me. Wait, hold on, hold on.
The second.
Wait, hold on. Are you trying to educate me about my deen? You're trying to tell me something that I study every day.
So you're telling me it's not about
You've got
Muhammad.
The wrong understanding of terminology of Islam. Because you're telling me something where all the Muslims are shaking their head.
So I'm asking you then, why are you praying towards Muhammad, where Muhammad was born?
We are praying to that direction because this is the new law we have to follow. Everyone has to pray
so
to
Muhammad
the direction.
Muhammad says pray towards me where I was born and you
he
do
never,
so.
Muhammad never said pray to me where I was born.
He
never
said pray to where he was born.
Muhammad
prayed towards the Kaaba and if you was born over there.
Where was
yes,
Muhammad?
Exactly. Yes.
He couldn't say that. He couldn't say pray to me directly.
Was
he picked the closest building right next to where he was born and says, okay, then you have to make it look like they're praying to God. Pray towards that
temple
building.
Of Solomon in Jerusalem.
And all of you guys are just
you said now Solomon done all of that for him. Come on, for Allah, that's it.
When it comes
and you are meant to be intelligent.
You're meant to be intelligent.
This one man has outwitted all of you. And you're all praying towards
it.
You guys, and that man never even know how to read and write. And he's got all you dumb people praying towards him every 5 times a day.
Did we pray to Muhammad or Allah?
Wait, hold on, brother. Did we pray to Muhammad or Allah?
Who commanded you to pray to
Muhammad?
Wait. Do we pray to Muhammad or Allah?
Who commanded you to pray to Muhammad?
Allah commanded that.
Muhammad.
No.
Did you
know what a messenger means?
Wait,
hold on.
Was it Muhammad?
Hold on. Do you know what a messenger means?
I know what a messenger means.
So, how could it be Muhammad telling him?
Muhammad's words, or is it God's words? How can you know the difference?
Because we could differentiate, because you could tell the way he's
perceived. There is no proof, there is no evidence.
I can say the same about Jesus.
He said Abraham built the house.
I can say the same about Jesus.
There is no proof, there is no evidence to say that Abraham. The history of the Kaaba is that it was a paganistic temple at 350 gods. There is no history, no proof in evidence.
Why did Moses go to Kaaba?
Why did Muhammad makes it.
Is there proof that Jesus died on the cross?
Yes. Four Gospels.
Who was the witness? Who was the witness?
There's no witnesses.
Who was the witness?
How do you get away with this stupidness?
Show me the witnesses.
How are you not so ignorant?
I'm not ignorant.
How is that so dumb?
You're ignorant.
Never.
I say, show me the witnesses.
Okay, then.
Who saw him?
I've got four. Okay, Mary, the mother of Jesus. John.
We don't have a gospel, man.
John got all four Gospels. Now.
We got Matthew,
Luke, and John. Now answer me this. Where is Muhammad's proof and evidence to say that Jesus never died? And where is the eyewitnesses?
Do you know what the proof is? Do you know what my proof? The Quran. That's my proof.
You fall victim to the same man.
You laugh, yeah. But you take the Bible as your criteria. You're laughing, and you take the Bible as your criteria. You've just told me the Bible is contradicting. And you told me God. You believe God's all perfect. Then if you believe God's all perfect, why would he send a book of contradiction?
The man says, pray to where I was born. And you pray to
never said
where
that.
You... Okay. Where he was
show
born.
Me
where
the verse. Where show me the verse or the tafsir or the hadith where it said Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Pray to where I was born."
Now the thing is, Muhammad is not gonna say, "Pray to where I was born," but he gave a building exactly near his location. And you Muslims are so can't think for yourself. You don't realize that he's manipulating you.
A pagan shrine. Kaaba was already a pagan shrine before Muhammad.
One sec, Baba.
Before Muhammad.
Baba, calm.
Your terminology to me is a disease because you can't witness the real difference between monotheism of worship. You can't realize that at the accorded time Allah wants you to pray and you would have to get an order for him for you to pray. Yeah? I don't know how you can see that we don't associate nothing with God. We pray to God directly, yeah? But you lot, we either associate Jesus, or you associate this person, or you associate that person. So what makes more sense when it comes down to monotheism, Islam or the Bible? What?
Okay, I hear what you're trying to come upon. What I'm trying to establish with you now is, did Muhammad take you for advantage of you. I'm going to go to Ramadan now. What is Ramadan about?
The Romans took a
hijab. What is Ramadan about?
Ramadan is about, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I give everything to you lot. Yeah? Only ask one thing I want from you is to fast from you. Yeah? So we don't do it because, to tell you the truth, most Muslims, if they wanted to do it for themselves, they're not fasting, bro.
What about prayer? Yeah.
Hold on. He's not asking about the prayer. He's not asking about prayer. He's not asking about Hajj.
I'm on your side. Relax. Yeah. Let there be some dialogue. Yeah. Go on.
No, we're number three. So I'm saying, go on, explain the Ramadan, and then I'll say what my version of the Ramadan is.
It's not your version. It's only one version. Okay?
Okay, then what's the version?
The version is
Islam
Allah
has a wrong version.
One second,
you're an Islamic scholar. I don't take it.
Thank God.
Okay.
Yes.
I need to know this. Okay, basically, Allah, He's gave everything to everyone. I mean, and everything's our will. We eat food, so you know Allah gives everything to everyone. Now, you, me, yeah, we have to. Wait, hold on.
You want me to give you time to gather your thoughts?
No. I just forgot because he interrupted, didn't it? But now, so Allah says, this is for me, fasting. You have to do something for me. There's no other way we can show Allah appreciation but the fast for the Ramadan. Yeah? Because if every Muslim, if they didn't do it for the sake of Allah and they waited to fast for themselves, you would never do it. You would never do it. So we do it for the sake of Allah. And to realize in remembrance that we're doing this for Allah, and to realize that certain things like our brothers and sisters, what they're going through in other countries when they're starving, many things, it's just not one portion. It's meant to be a blessed month where we can get reward, where we realize each other as Muslims, to get more closer to our God,
cleanse the body.
This is what Ramadan's for. This is what the scholars say.
Can I say something? Ramadan is conducted during the time in which Muhammad was in the cage getting a publicity for the Quran. Yeah? What? Am I wrong?
One time.
Now, the Ramadan is basically about Muhammad again in a cave getting prophecy. Is there anything you have in the five pillars that is not about Muhammad?
Do you know what prophecy is?
When did
you know what a prophecy is?
Yeah.
Okay, so when he's in the cave,
we know very
when
well.
We're in the cave, what is prophecy? Getting revelation about certain things. Yeah? You think this is wrong because Ramadan's on that day?
Ramadan is about.
Why did Jesus fast?
Jesus fasted for 40 days and 40
why?
Nights.
Why? Yet, you was for Moses.
Yet,
why?
Yet we Moses do not. Yet we do not have a period where we're fasting the same time as Jesus. Whereas in Islam, they have
doesn't
a time fasting. Yes, it does.
He's a prophet. Because he should know more than you.
Because Muhammad is using religion, his status as a prophet, to gain power.
He already had a power.
There's 10 commandments.
They need moon to fast.
One second, Baba.
Yeah, they need moon to fast.
613 laws in the Bible, and none of them mention any of the prophets. When it comes to the first five pillars of Islam, it's all about Muhammad. Muhammad has used the term prophet to gain power, to gain control, and has used people, manipulated people by using the term prophet.
Yeah, and this
there is no
Islam. It's not a religion.
No facts that he brings. No facts.
Why does Google say he's the best role model to all the earth? If
you're
right.
You're gonna go by Google. No, that's all the way down here, brother.
No, wait. No, basically,
Islam is not for the people of the earth.
Manipulated. Hold on. I'm not going off topic. You made a claim Muhammad manipulated people using his religion to conduct people to the religion, but still non-Muslims say he's the best role model to walk the earth. How do you make that?
So basically,
ask them.
Because of Muhammad's actions. Now I can't.
What actions?
His actions of sleeping with Aisha. Yeah. Now the fact is this. Yeah.
How old was Joseph when he slept with Mariam?
Have you got any?
He was 90. She was 12. Have you got a problem with that? Have you got a problem with that?
No, too.
Have you got a problem?
She was a nerd.
She was a nerd.
She was 12.
She was a nerd.
Was 90.
Show me that.
Your biblical scholars.
Bible doesn't say. Bible doesn't say.
Now
she was a nerd. She was a nerd.
No, don't try it. Don't try swing the apple where you want it, bro. Yeah, don't try swing the apple where you want it. Mariam was 12. Mariam was 12. No. Joseph had
sex with her.
And
Islam is not for the people of North. Because there is no moon there. For 6 months at least, there is no moon in North. So Islam is not for the people of North.
Baba, I'm on your side. Calm down.
So how can this religion be a religion of for whole humanity? How can that be?
Okay. Say you're calm,
yeah?
Brother, is it wrong for a man to sleep with a 12-year-old child?
Oh, yes, it is.
I think it's wrong.
Yeah, it
Do
is
you
very,
think
very
it's wrong that a man shouldn't sleep with a 12-year-old child?
53 years old, man.
Come, let him answer. Yeah. The ball's in his court now.
One second.
I said it's wrong for a man to sleep with a 12-year-old. He said it's wrong for a man to sleep with a 12-year-old. Is it wrong for a man? Okay, go on.
Let me finish.
Just one topic, man.
When it comes to Islam, when you come into a position of adult, when you're old enough, because kids can't have kids, a kid can't bear another child. So when you come into an adult, you are perceived to, when you start getting feelings, you want to have sex with someone, you should get married.
9 years?
Did I say 9 years?
9 years?
Did I say 9 years?
Where is it?
No.
Or 6 years?
I'm asking you a simple question.
The scholars say the perceived age when a woman can get married and have intercourse is 15.
Do you have a scholar say? So you're saying to me as an Islamic man, as a Muslim, that it's wrong for a man to sleep with a woman at the age of 12. You should be what a scholar said at the age of 15.
She wouldn't be a woman if she was 12.
Please show to these Muslims, because these Muslims don't understand. I speak to Muslims regularly and they say to me,
thinking,
it's okay.
He's thinking Western, sex, and all this stuff.
10-year-old, it's okay for a man to sleep with a 30-year-old.
It was okay for 10 years ago.
Let me clap your hand. You're one of the only Muslims I've heard to say that it's wrong for a man to sleep with a 12-year-old.
Right now, yes.
Well done.
Right now.
Well done.
Let me explain something. If my daughter was 15 and she come to me and said, Dad, I think I'm going to commit zina, I think I need to get married, and she come with me this, I'm marrying her because I don't want her to do wrong.
15,
I don't, yeah? Yeah, 15, right. I'm marrying her.
16 is girls, but...
The most 15 and 16 year olds have sex in today. Do they?
It's still wrong.
What? I swear Great Britain has the worstest underage pregnancy. Yeah, why do you think this is? There's no sharia saying that you can only have sex when you're married.
What is your agenda, by the way?
My agenda is to say that Islam, religion, is too much about Muhammad. Muhammad has used the status as a prophet to take advantage of people. to use to get power, to get on wealth, not wealth, but power and influence.
Yo, why are you shaking your head? That's what the Romans done with your Bible. They exactly done that with your Bible. Oh. Romans.
Oh.
Do you know who Mithras
is?
Do you know who Mithras is? Do you know who Mithras is? Do you know who Mithras is?
It's not set in stone.
What
Mithras.
Is that? What is that?
He is a sun god, a Greek sun god who died for people's sins, rose on the first day, yes, and had three gods within one.
Bible doesn't say this.
Yeah, but this is the God.
Bible doesn't say this.
The same description you look like Jesus. Romans put it in.
Not even Quran talk. Not even Quran talk about this.
Research me for us.
Not even Quran.
Research me for us.
Quran doesn't say this.
Research me for us, sun god. Greek mythology, Romans brought into your Bible. I promise you.
The reason why I'm asking you this, yeah, is because obviously it seems as though you're serving a certain agenda, because you chose the most extreme age when it's arranged. It's not set in stone. Some people say 18, there's evidence for 18. Some people say 12, there's evidence for 12. But yet you went for the most lowest range, reason being because you wanted to demonize the prophet, because that suits your agenda better.
No. I never come with the age of 12.
Wait
a second, let me finish. This gentleman came with the age of 12. He was trying to use it to say that Joseph married Mary at the age, and I'm adding intercourse at the age of 12. He banged at the age of 12.
Okay, but
you banged at the age of 12. And allow paedophilia to carry on. A lot of Muslims come and say it's not about the age, it's about the time which they reach puberty. Now the youngest age of child that ever reached puberty was in Peru, a 3-year-old, and a man that had intercourse with her at the age of 5. So you can't use the term puberty to say whether or not it's right or wrong. So when I speak to Muslims and I try to say to them what age is wrong, a lot of the time they're just on that
age.
Same, they're all exactly, okay, it's about that age. So if I say to this man
it's
now,
mentally and physically.
If I say to this man now, okay then, a 12-year-old, a 11-year-old, a 9-year-old, a 10-year-old, they become, they have puberty, and then they are willing and they're mature enough to get mature in their head to get married. Are they allowed to be married?
So this man, a 10-year-old, a 11-year-old, is allowed to get married. What is the definition of paedophilia? According to you, what's the definition?
A child.
Okay, so it's puberty.
That's
okay, if someone hit puberty, it's still a child.
That's why Islam is promoting muta.
Wait, hold on.
That's why Islam is promoting muta.
Okay, can I talk, please?
Yes, yes,
muta, bro, just be quiet. We don't do muta.
That's why Islam is promoting muta.
We don't do muta.
Yeah, you do. You do muta here.
I'm not telling you about the muta, bro. Malcolm, you said that the brother was
married, bro.
You said that the brother was promoting paedophilia. I asked you what is the definition of paedophilia? You said having sex with a child. But is someone who's hit puberty a child?
Yes.
How?
Can a child have a child?
Okay then. A 9-year-old has not got the maturity.
A 9-year-old has not got the maturity to
get married, to have sex with a much of an older man, and to endorse that.
I agree with you in that sense. There's no doubt about that. But what I'm saying is, you've chose the utmost extreme. When there's evidence, would you agree there's evidence to suggest that Aisha was 18 at the time? There's evidence to suggest she was 16 at the time. In the Quran, it says a marriage is not valid unless it's entered into by two consenting adults.
This is the mind of the Westerners. They think.
And that's my next point. In this day and age,
Sahil Bukhari.
Okay, one second.
Sahil Bukhari, they talk, he talk
okay,
about
that. Malcolm, I'm just going to address you, yeah? I'm going to address you. We know Aisha was engaged before she even married the Prophet. She was engaged. She was engaged to someone else.
No.
That's one narrative,
the Sahih
Bukhari
says,
number two, at the
Aisha,
age of Hijra,
Aisha was still playing with the dolls.
Listen, okay.
Playing with the dolls.
Listen, okay.
She was still playing with the dolls.
Brother, yeah. Don't talk over him. Yeah?
You can. Oh! So are you a Islamic scholar?
I know you, brother. You got a lot of passion. You got a lot of passion, but you have to control it. Yeah. Have a dialogue. Let them reason themselves out of the situation, and we can reason ourselves out.
The thing,
you know?
He's talking. Bro.
Okay.
Yeah, I know.
You keep interrupting when I think I'm gonna lose my train of thought. That's why he's saying that. Yeah. But let me just go back to that top. I was saying. Yeah. So she was number one. She was engaged. Some people say she's 6 years old. Some people say she wasn't. Yeah. If you look at it mathematically, yeah, she had a sister, an older sister by 10 years, named Esma. Yeah. After Hijrah, 90 years after Hijrah, she died at 100 years old. Yeah. We know from Hadith that Esma died at 100 years old, 90 years after Hijrah. So what would that make? Hijrah is, I think it was 2 years before Hijrah when Aisha got married to the Prophet. Yeah. Or sorry, 2 years after Hijrah when Aisha got married to the Prophet. So then, mathematically speaking, how old was Aisha when she got married to the Prophet? If her sister, who died at 100 years old, 90 years later, how old was she?
I ain't that good at math, brother. You can
it would say that she's 18.
All right then.
You say she's 18.
That's fine.
Okay, but no, I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that's the truth. I'm not saying that's the truth. What I'm saying is, it's a disputed matter. Okay. Yeah? And we know, if you look at it objectively, we know God answers that.
Either you are wrong or Sahih Bukhari.
Okay.
Sahih Bukhari is wrong.
Okay, that's wicked.
Either you are wrong,
okay.
Sahih Muslim is wrong.
Okay.
Either you are wrong or Sahih Bukhari is wrong.
Okay.
Either you are wrong or Sahih Muslim is wrong. Because both the books, they are talking about that Aisha was 6 years old when Muhammad was engaged with her. And Muhammad took her on the bed when she was 9. And also that hadith says that Aisha was playing with the doll at that time.
Okay, Malcolm, addressing what he just said, yeah? I'll address what he just said, yeah? So, that's true. These are hadith that say this in Sahih Bukhari, but you have to remember, this is a revelation. Sahih just means strong. It means there's a strong narration. There's also conflicting narrations that say she was 18, that say she's 14. But this isn't revelation. We don't go on this. It's an unclear matter. Do you understand what I'm trying to say? My dispute is that you've chosen to go
then
with the utmost...
Then how can this be a Sahih? Then how is
brother,
is
do you know what Sahih means?
Huh?
Do you know what Sahih means?
Yeah.
What does it mean?
Sahih means perfect.
Okay.
Sahih means perfect.
This is not qualified to talk
this anymore. Is Arabic word.
You're not qualified to
talk Sahih means perfect.
Sahih means strong.
That book is a perfect.
Is only Sahih.
That is giving the wrong information. Or either you are giving the wrong information.
Do you speak Arabic? You speak Arabic language. I study Arabic.
Thank God. I study Arabic.
I'm telling you, someone speaks Arabic. Sahih doesn't mean perfect.
Come on. The problem is not whether the dispute even whether she was 9 or whether she was 18. This is where my dispute lies. I asked the gentleman just to your left there, and I said to him, the woman, the girl, is 9, is 10, 11, she's 12. Yeah? I said, she's had gone through puberty and she wants to get married.
Okay.
Is it alright for she to get married? And the man said, who was a Muslim, he said, it's perfectly, it's okay.
It's better than her. Now that kind of ideology,
to me is paedophilia.
Okay, can I respond?
Because at such a young age, that's a lot. That's epidemic.
Can I respond?
Can I respond?
Let me just respond, brother. I just want to say one thing. Okay.
And to me, Islam is promoting paedophilia.
Okay, can I just respond now? Really quickly, yeah? I just want to respond really quickly, yeah? Look.
Don't go there.
When you get
the verse now.
When you get Muslims, you are saying it's okay.
Well,
a girl of 9, 10,
Malcolm,
who is at puberty and says they are wanting to get married,
okay.
they are
allowed to... Don't fall into the trap. But Malcolm, you know what you're doing.
Most non-Muslim children at the age, young age, go out and have sex, do they not? To this day and age?
Is it right?
Wait, hold on. No, I'm saying, do they do it?
I don't know, brother.
No, you do know. You do know, because we have that
under the Sahil Bukhari here.
Malcolm, yeah. Come back to the topic. Yeah? What you're doing is very dangerous. Have you ever heard the term? I'm going to address two matters here. Have you ever heard the term throwing stones when you live in a glass house? That's what you're doing. So, what the brother rightly pointed out is, yeah, that these same ideas are found in the Bible. So, this atheistic position that you're taking doesn't work for you, doesn't do anything for you. That's number one. Number two, yeah, would you agree that depending on where you are and when you are in the world, the adulthood is treated differently? For example, in places like the Emirates, places like Morocco, you work at a very young age. You're taught to work at a young age, 8 years old.
My dear brother.
Okay, number two. Okay, so the definition of pedophilia here is having sex with someone underage, yeah?
Aisha is talking here. Listen carefully.
The age of consent. The age of consent.
Aisha is talking here.
Okay, brother.
Aisha is talking here.
Listen to your brother.
Okay. Listen carefully.
You can talk after me.
Aisha is talking here.
Okay, you're right. Okay, you're right.
Aisha narrated. The prophet married me.
No one wants to hear you.
Prophet married me at the age of 6 years.
Okay, that's good.
And he consummated married at the age of 9.
Okay.
This is Sahih Bukhari. Sahih Bukhari. And Aisha is talking
about
this.
Okay, thank you.
Aisha is giving the information.
We appreciate
you. You are wrong.
Okay, we appreciate
you. You are absolutely wrong.
We appreciate your input.
You are absolutely wrong. I am giving the wrong information.
Okay, because this is what happens, right? I lose my train of thought, right? Yeah? Okay, now. Okay. Now, the third point that I'm going to make, yeah? Pedophilia, according to you, is having sex with someone, a child. A child, in the eyes of the law, is someone who's underage. Now, I'll ask you this question. The age of consent here is 16. The age of consent in America is 18. Who's wrong? If a 17-year-old was having sex in America, they'll be considered a minor. If a 17-year-old has sex here, they're considered. So the point I'm trying to make is that it's subjective to social construct. Yeah? We're dealing with God. Us lot here, we're dealing with God. You understand? You're a man of God. So you can't use this atheistic, orientalist, you are, bro. That's
I'm
a
saying,
you
are. Because
you can't preach against something that you bribe.
That
you
prophet.
That you religion proves.
I'm talking about religion. I'm talking about France.
Wrong is the wrong.
I'm talking about France.
The prophet.
In France, at the age of 13, you are allowed to have sex. Yeah? You're allowed to have sex. Are the French government wrong for letting people have sex at 13?
Wrong.
Yes or no?
Wrong is a wrong everywhere. Where you go?
Whether it is the prophet or human. It's subjective. Do you want to say it's something subjective?
But what I'm trying to say to you is this, yeah? We would have no Christian here. I've never seen any Christian say it's okay to sleep with to get married to a 12-year-old, 11-year-old, a 10-year-old. Never heard it.
Yeah.
But in Islam, I hear that a lot.
Yeah.
Not if
because of the actions of your prophet. No, I'm not here
to think. As soon as they come into administration, marriage is not like that. You have to prepare for marriage.
I'm not trying to say anything against your prophet. A different time,
listen,
a different age.
Listen,
I'm talking about the Muslims.
The bottom line,
now.
You know, the bottom line is, according to the Quran, marriage is only valid if it's entered into by two consenting adults. That's the bottom line, bro. What's that trying to say? That's the bottom. Okay, she's not, exactly. A 9-year-old is not a consenting adult. Exactly, and we treat the Quran as it's more authoritative. It transcends hadith. It transcends anything else on this earth, bro. That's what I'm trying to say. So why are you gonna go and point towards something that men differed upon when we have revelation from God?
We're gonna go one. We're gonna go one from speaking about marriage and marriage age.
Good.
The next point, zakat. Because we're going through the five pillars, and I'm demonstrating that
all of them
are about marriages. What do you mean? Ramadan is about Muhammad.
Wait a second, brother.
Ramadan is based upon when Muhammad was in the cave getting the recitation. You can tell me.
us with the recitations of the Quran.
Based upon what Allah wants from the human race. That's what it's based upon.
Why that date? Basically. Why that time?
What date and what time? Ramadan comes to time according to a moon. It's not a date. Allah gives us a sign of it.
Whereas your books are talking differently.
Because God wants people, his Muslims, his believers, what he wants them to do Ramadan for his sake, for the sake of Allah.
Okay.
That's the whole point of Ramadan. It's not the point that you say in the game.
Ramadan has got nothing to do with Muhammad getting the reciting of the Quran. It's got nothing to do with that.
Malcolm, you know why your point fails, bro?
Why?
Because revelation came over a period of 23 years. It never just happened in a cave at once.
How can this be a miracle? You must know then why the month of Ramadan. Instant.
Why I'm asking you? Why the month of Ramadan must
miracle has to be
fast?
Miracle has to be instant.
Why the month of Ramadan must be fast?
God told us to fast for several reasons. Discipline. One of them is to put us in the shoes of other people. And so say that again, Baba.
Commandment.
Yeah. It's for his sake.
When certain Passovers or laws and dates are given, it's for a reason. God gave, when Israel left Egypt, God said, this is a new day, this is a new year, the beginning of for you. That's the reason why their date started at that particular time. At the time of the Passover of unleavened bread, that was during the period of the Passover, when God passed over the Egyptians, passed over the Jewish people, and killed the Egyptians. It's reasons, it's times and dates given with reasons. I'm asking you the time and date reason given with Ramadan, and you have failed to come up with the reason and the date on which Muhammad gave you the Ramadan. Please, can you incite, teach me, and let me know.
How is it benefiting you?
My statement is that Ramadan is about Muhammad yet again. All of the five pillars is about Muhammad.
You're giving your own suggestion. Let me give you the dalil. Surah Al-Fatiha is the first ayah. All praise be to Allah. It doesn't say Muhammad. Where's your dalil on your claim?
Muhammad.
Where is your evidence on your claim?
Let me give you the dalil.
Okay.
Let me give you the dalil. If Muhammad was a fake prophet.
There is no stop in between.
Baba, I know, but he's looking for Dalil. I'm speaking to him.
Please, Baba, relax.
What was I talking about?
You were saying the first idea.
Yeah, the Surah, it says, all praise be to Allah. You keep saying, Muhammad this, Muhammad that. Muhammad never ever claimed once it was for him. He never said, worship me. He never said, follow me in the sense of just follow me. He always said, follow Allah. Yeah? Okay. The only way to obey Allah is to obey the messenger. The same in Jesus said, I am the truth, I am the way and the light. Only way to follow his teachings from God was to follow him. So what you're trying to say now, you're trying to pick and choose all these little things to justify your little theory. It's never going to work.
What did Muhammad say in Bukhari 1, volume 1, book 1, you know, volume 2, verse 23. What did he say? He said, you must love. This has got nothing to do with Allah. He said, you must love me.
I must love him, I must love you, I must love humanity.
Muhammad said you must love me more than your family. You must love me more than your children. That's what Muhammad said.
Wait.
No, this is meant to be. This is meant to be
digging a hole. Your Bible, says,
tell it.
Yeah, as the companion, you must kill your mother, father, daughter, everyone.
Yeah, say kill your mother.
Hate your mother and father. Hate your mother and father.
Let me give him a delil. Hate your mother and father.
You must hate your mother.
Let me give him a delil here.
It says worse than that, isn't it?
Can you listen?
It says kill.
Can you listen to the delil now? You want a delil? Let me give you.
You're trying to tell me in the Bible there's no murder verses.
I'm not saying that there's no murder verses.
So who, if Jesus is so perfect, who came with the murder verses?
Let's go on.
You keep saying Muhammad this, Muhammad that. You're a believer of Jesus.
Muhammad said you must love me. You said that Muhammad has not used his status to get power, to claim glory.
Yes.
He hasn't used that.
Yes.
So I'm asking you, why has he said you must love me more than your family?
You must say it six times. I love Muhammad more than my family. Do you know why? Do you know why I love Muhammad more than my family? Because for my mum, he's teach me how to be a man, how to be respectable to people, how to honor another person, how to follow my religion, how to love another person. No one, the man's dead. I've never met him. He's taught me this. He's taught me this.
Did he give you life?
Never. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No.
The third commandment is honor thy mother and thy father.
What?
Yeah. Moses never said you must honor me more than your father and mother.
That's right.
Why is Muhammad come and say you must honor me or love me?
Good point.
You have to understand Islam. Yeah? That's why.
All about Muhammad.
No, it's not all about Muhammad.
Can you guys all
listen? Cool, you are not letting me talk.
Let me.
It's meant to be back and forth, innit? Cool. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yeah? You have to love him, so you listen and obey him. And you have to obey him because his messages come from Allah.
Not only him, all the other prophets as well.
Islam is not something...
You know where this spark is.
You need to listen more than that as well. You need to listen...
It's always been here.
You need to listen Abraham as well. You need to listen Isaiah as well.
Do you?
Yeah.
Do you? You
need
to listen to another.
I don't listen Muhammad. I listen Abraham. I listen Moses. Isaiah.
You listen to what the Quran says and Hadith, and the Bible has to be in agreement to it. If it's not in agreement to it, you don't believe it. So you don't believe what Muhammad says. It's all about Muhammad.
Listen, let me tell you
something. About Muhammad. Islam is all about Muhammad.
It's a proof of that.
If you're not going to let me talk, I'm going to have to walk.
Come on.
I swear I'm going to have to walk.
I gave you bed to call.
Cool. Are you trying to say Prophet Muhammad is a fake prophet?
It's not the word of God.
Is he not the word of God?
Yes or no? I have to say yes.
Okay, so
it's all abrogated.
Prophet Muhammad was a fake prophet. He would have said, my mum is the best mum who ever walked on fire, and she's going paradise. Why would he say my mum's going hell, and Maria, Jesus' mum, was the best mum to walk on earth, and she's going heaven? If he was a liar, he would have said, this religion is just for the Arabs.
So come
just for the Arabs, you didn't say that. He said, this religion is for everyone. Yeah? He said, this religion is for everyone. Muhammad was a liar. When he told us Arabs will be competing for buildings, tall buildings. In the day of age, there was no such thing as Arabs. Where are the highest buildings now you see today?
The God who is three in one.
So is he lying that what he saw from
the God who is three in one? Even you are three in one. You are a replica of that Trinity on this earth.
He said specific nature of people, Arabs.
He's
talking about a Pacific nation of people who compete for tall buildings till today. So you are telling me he was lying about that prophecy?
I'm not saying he's lying, brother.
You just said he was a liar.
Now, what after you banged
him? Hold on. Do you actually know the history of Prophet Muhammad?
I know a lot.
Do you know anything about before he was a prophet?
That Uri married another lady.
Do you know he was called a man of truth? That people used to go and give his possessions and things to before he was a prophet. So why is he going to lie now he's a prophet?
He's used prophet status. I can, like I said already, I can go for all the pillars. It's all about Muhammad. The hadith, all about Muhammad.
To follow his sunnah.
And the hadith.
Okay, look, is Muhammad alive? Is Muhammad alive?
How much more?
Wait, is Muhammad alive? Peace and blessings, is Muhammad alive? So if Muhammad is not alive, wait, hold on. If Muhammad's not alive, how are you going to receive his information?
Now, 1 second, Baba. Now, back in the day, the prophets always passed on to another prophet. What Muhammad went and did, because he wanted all the power for himself, wanted to put down all the other prophets.
No. For Jesus, 13 years, he had no power. Jesus, so what are you talking about?
Jesus was a threat to him. So he said, Jesus never died for your sins.
That's why.
Put that in one parable.
The Bible says Jesus was a threat to him.
The Bible says Jesus, no child can bear a sin of another. What are you talking about? What are you talking about? That's in your book. What are you talking about? Jesus never died for your sins. No sin will bear another. A child will bear sin of another.
Baba, let me talk now.
Okay, cool, I will let you talk.
Now, in Muhammad went against Jesus very, very hard. He said that there is God has no son. Now, even in Genesis, it talks about the sons of God.
Yeah.
God told Moses to go to Pharaoh and say, Israel is my firstborn son. Yeah. David talked about son of God. Jesus said, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son.
I didn't understand.
Gabriel said, this is the son.
This is
Gabriel said, Jesus, the son you want to have to marry, what's the son mean? Biological son, spiritual son, Muhammad makes a claim that God has no son, and yet he contradicts all the other prophets, a lot of the other prophets, and contradicts God himself.
Hold on, you contradict God, because God creates, yeah? One minute, God creates, am I right? When God made Adam, the first of his creation, did he breed him or create him?
Why would you say Jesus was created? Why did he have to die? I'm saying the term of the Son of God is used by many prophets, used by God, used by the angel Gabriel, and obviously by Jesus. For God so loved the world, he gave his only son. And Muhammad comes along and calls them all a liar.
Can I say something? Show me. In the Quran, it says God has no son.
Even
in your own Bible, it tells you they lie even falsely.
David, to David, God said, this is my firstborn, beloved. But we don't call David a God.
How can Jesus be firstborn when
David is a God?
This is what they don't make sense. You're confusing me, bro. Huh? How can Jesus be the firstborn when Allah created Adam? First, you know who the human person being was.
He's the firstborn.
There we go.
Adam wasn't born though.
This is what Adam was born.
No, he wasn't born. He was created.
Then why did you compare it?
Because contradiction.
No, it's not a contradiction.
Baba, we're going to read the scripture. Relax. And the Lord said unto Moses, when thou goest to return him to Egypt, see that thou do all those wonders before Pharaoh which I have put in thine hands. But I will harden his heart, that he shall not let the people go. And thou shalt say unto Pharaoh, thus saith the Lord, Israel, my son, even my firstborn. This is God talking to Moses, and he calls Israel his son, his firstborn. Muhammad said, God has no son. Yeah. He directly contradicts God's word.
You just took everything out of context. When Prophet Muhammad is talking, he's talking about Jesus. He's not talking about the sons of Israel.
No.
He's talking about Isa himself. He says he was begotten and he had a son.
He says God has no son.
Yeah, no son.
Full stop.
Did he say son or sons?
He doesn't have sons.
So exactly, that may not.
Yeah, of course it makes sense, because everyone's got son, not just Jesus. Yeah? Because Jesus...
We don't say everybody
God. Old Testament, brother. In the Old Testament, it says all of you, everyone's a son of God.
Listen, does that make sense
to you? It doesn't make sense.
He doesn't believe in a book.
You know it doesn't make sense.
Who says that? Who does that? Do you know my perception on the Bible?
Do you believe in the Bible?
Do you know my perception?
Do you believe in the Bible?
Wait, hold on. Do you know my perception?
Do you believe in the Bible?
Just say no.
Do you believe in the Bible?
Yes or no,
brother? Just say no.
Yes or no?
Can you answer my question? Do you believe in the Bible?
I believe in whatever the Quran backs up, yeah.
Exactly.
So you're not believing in the Bible then?
I don't believe what the men put in, no.
He only believes what Muhammad says.
Yeah, what you Romans, the Romans.
Romans.
Yes, Roman Empire.
You just...
Wait, one minute. Do you Christians know who Mithras is? Do any of you know who Mithras is?
Look.
No, wait, hold on. Do you know? Do you know who Mithras is?
Listen to this one. If the Bible...
Hold on. Answer my question, please.
Hold on. I'm going to answer your question.
Do you know who Mithras is?
If the Bible... Can I...
Read Mithras.
Go
home. Right, go home.
Read Mithras. People, how can you debate?
Read Mithras, yeah? And then after you read Mithras, you're going to see this is the same description they put in the Bible of Jesus.
No, wait.
I promise you.
According to his... The word of Allah can't be changed. Allah is the one who gave the Bible.
That's
this book.
Right.
Jews,
no.
Hold on. The Quran. We're not talking about
Christians.
Yeah.
Now,
we're not talking about the books before. We're talking about the Quran. It cannot be changed. It has to be changed in the language that came down.
Allah was...
Who is it?
You got it wrong.
Either he or Allah.
According to your God, can his voice be changed?
The Quran, no.
No, it's not. I'm not talking about Quran. It doesn't mention Quran there. Yeah. It doesn't mention Quran.
Quran,
don't add voice to the Quran. Don't add voice.
Yes,
it doesn't say that.
What I can see from evidence,
it doesn't say Quran. Hold on. Listen.
The
verse.
Has the Bible been changed?
The verse.
Has the Bible been changed?
Of course not. How can it be changed?
No, it's not changed.
But if it's changed, your God is a liar then.
Yes.
Your God become a liar then.
Yeah,
because he said his voice can't be changed.
Wait, one minute.
How?
Bible will not be changed.
Listen, if the Bible has been changed, that's bad news for you.
For you.
Because your God is a liar then.
You follow it.
Because your God says his voice can't be changed.
My God, see my God, he doesn't leave us stranded. So when your book gets contaminated, he says a new revelation.
Who gave the Torah?
Hold on. To back up
what
he says.
Who gave the Torah to Moses?
Allah.
Okay, can the word of Allah be changed?
Yeah. A lot of times, yeah.
So who's time then?
Yeah.
Why you guys says his voice can't be changed?
So Allah is a deficient.
So it's a contradiction.
He's talking about...
Yeah.
How do you know what book he's talking about?
How
do you know what book he's talking about?
If you prove it, he only talks about the Quran, I'll give you whatever you want.
Wait, how do you know what book he's talking about?
Can I back
it? How do you know?
Back it up. You guys just come with random speech.
Can I get a
tasfir? I don't have no idea what you're talking about. Look, you said, he said, that scripture talks about the Quran only. And I told you, it doesn't mention
that.
It just talks from nowhere. Can I answer his question? He doesn't talk about any books.
Yeah, so how do you know?
He talks about his word.
Message.
He doesn't, in that scripture, let me finish. That is scripture, it just says his words can't be changed. It doesn't mention any book. It doesn't mention Bible. It doesn't mention the Quran. It just says his words can't be changed. So why do you say no? It's only the Quran. It doesn't say that.
Okay, do you have the tafsir for that verse?
Tafsir.
Doesn't matter.
Do you have the tafsir for
that? Okay. Would the tafsir change what is written there?
Do you have the tafsir for the explanation of the verse?
Do you have it?
Yes. Do you have the explanation of the
Bible? I don't. Do you have it?
No, I don't have it.
So, you don't have it? Can you back it up? Can you back it up?
If you made a claim, who backs it up?
No, but you're disagreeing as well.
Listen.
Are you disagreeing?
When you talk about, what I'm trying to say is, yeah, when you talk about the Quran, no, of course I can back it up.
You can't back it up.
Of course I can back it up.
You disagree with me.
Of course I can back it up.
I can't back it up.
Of course I can back it up. When you talk about the Quran and you're bringing verses, what you're establishing, what you think is true, you need to come with something called a tafsir.
I'm just reading what it says.
No,
I'm just reading what it says.
But Allah says in the Quran, I bring clear verses and unclear verses.
One second.
So when you have unclear verses, you refer to
that's your problem again. You have contradiction in the Quran.
No, you don't. There's no contradiction.
Really?
There's no contradiction.
It is
an explanation. Do you know the difference between contradiction and explanation?
Yeah.
There's full of contradiction in the Quran.
Get me two contradictions.
So, okay,
how I'm challenging you to get me two contradictions. Yes, yeah. Two of them.
Okay,
of them.
How many angels were sent to Maryam? One or more than one?
One.
How many?
One.
You sure?
Yeah.
So if I show you scripture in the Quran that mentioned that it's more than one angel has been sent, what would you do?
Open the chapter. Go and go get the chapter.
No, no. Would you leave Islam then?
Just no. We never leave Islam.
So what's the point of me then?
Get the chapter up. Let's establish it. You're saying. So let's get the evidence on the
listen,
table.
You just get
and
deal
with it instead of us arguing each other.
You need to back it up, yeah.
And then I'm gonna go on my phone and get the tafsir, yeah. And then we'll deal with it.
But remember, the tafsir won't be able to change the word.
The tafsir is the explanation of the word.
But it can't change the word.
It's the explanation.
That's a matter. It can't change the word.
It's explanation. The explanation.
Look, there's verse. The explanation.
Do you have?
Can't come up and.
We don't have a Holy Spirit in our. We don't have a Holy Spirit in our religion. We have something. It's called resolving things in our religion. And we have tafsir, hadith, things we can resolve.
And those are written by men.
No.
And you rely on it.
Your book's written by a man.
Wait, what is tafsir written by?
What do you believe in? What do you believe in?
It's narration.
Answer.
It's narration.
Who is it written by?
Yeah, it's written by a man.
So you're following a man then?
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Do you follow the
Muhammad
book?
Was a messenger from Allah. No. It's a man we follow.
Do you follow the tafsir?
No, I don't think it's
me. Of course we have to follow tafsir.
Is tafsir written by men?
It's his explanation of the Prophet, narration.
Answer the question.
I'm answering your question.
Is it written by men?
It's an explanation.
Is it written by men?
Okay. Can you bring me the Injil?
So you're following men.
Where's the Injil? Where's the Injil?
Quran is being abrogated.
Jeremiah 8:8.
Is there a constriction in the Quran?
Wait.
Is there a constriction in the Quran?
No, there's no constriction.
Okay. So, explain that to me, yeah? Which one was created first? The earth or the sky? Which one was created first? According to the Quran.
You elaborate.
No, I'm asking you the question.
You elaborate.
Have you read the Quran? Have you read the Quran?
I've read the Quran.
Okay, according to what you read, which is the Quran, one was created
He's
first?
The claims.
The earth or the skies? Which one was created first?
You're making the claims of
I'm not making the claims. You, I'm asking you a question.
No.
You said you have read the question. You have read the Quran, right?
I'm not answering until you finish.
Have you read the Quran?
Allah.
Have you read the Quran?
Yes, I've read the Quran.
Okay, so answer that question. According to the Quran, which one was created first? The earth, the ground, or the skies? Which one was created first? According to what you read, which is the Quran. Answer the question, please.
Don't worry. I'm gonna get it out. What verse is this?
I have no idea, but it's the ayah where it says everything was together.
Surah 2, ayah 29. It says first the sky, then the earth. Surah 79, ayah 27, 30, it says the opposite.
Yeah, what's the opposite? Read it out for the camera.
The translation?
No, I don't have it there. It's there.
But
you have the Quran. You're not a Muslim.
It's valid.
Go read it then.
Do you know what contradicts?
No, Hold on.
Okay, I'm going to look for it. Do everyone know what a contradiction means?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. So when you have something, what contradicts something? You said something, but you ain't showed the contradiction.
This is what he said.
I'm just telling you.
This is what he said.
You I'm just come up with a claim.
Can I go to the verse?
Say it.
Go to the verse. I don't speak Arabic.
If I make a claim, if I make a claim, I have to back it up.
Can you read it?
If I make a claim.
I don't back it up. I give you the verse.
No, you said one.
Did I give you the verse?
Yeah. Where's the
Let's go to the next one.
Where's the contradiction?
Let's go to the next one.
The contradiction is very clear.
You want to find another one?
Get the contradiction out. That's all I want to see.
Surah 19. Surah 19, it says.
Let him do. Please, uncle, let him. Let him deal
one
with the situation,
angel, and that is Gabriel,
who came to Mary.
Okay, yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
But in now, at other place, at other place,
come on.
Eight angels came.
According to
Mary,
the Quran, right,
so which is
where
which
does
is
right evil come from?
Until you
where, what is the reason for
one
evil?
Time, one
so what is going to contradict all that you just said about the creation of the sky?
No, that's another contradiction. That was a different one. The contradiction was one verse talks about the sky was created first, then the earth. One of them says the earth was created first, then the sky. That's a contradiction. Right? Now, you can't go and read it.
I didn't hear you say that. You said one thing, then I asked you for the contradiction. He's like, no, you get it.
You back it up. The claim is for me to give you the reference.
Yeah.
And you go and read it. That's the backup.
I'm reading it, but you're making the claim.
So and I'm backing it up. I'm giving you the verse.
You're meant to back it up and present yourself.
Okay, that's how I back it up. I give you the verse.
This is
how you back it up.
How
should I back it up then?
It's not backing it up.
Okay, what is backing up according to you?
You read the verse.
Yes.
Then you read the other verse.
And
then
you explain.
Justify this to me.
Okay, so if I give you the reference and you read it, is that the same thing then? Why not? Explain
if I
that.
Make a claim,
no,
explain that logic. Claim, I have to back it up.
Explain that logic. What difference
you're not making no
does
logic.
It make? Se- what difference does it make? I read
he's
it, but you read it.
It does make
you're running
it.
Away.
Because you read it, you're
running away.
Because you know, when you read it, okay. You read it, I'm going to
basically, read it. Basically, you're running away now.
It's different than you reading it, right?
He's
so
running away.
If I read it, it's going to be a different word according to what you read.
No, just read what you're saying.
I'm telling you,
so we can establish.
Wait.
Can I
the
say
scriptures
one thing?
Are there for you to read.
No.
Can I say one thing?
You just said to me.
Listen, that's your problem.
I said to you.
No, I'm not going to read it.
Wait,
it's
on,
for
on,
you
on,
to read.
It's your problem.
I said to him.
No,
I tell
have a problem.
You.
It's
I made
for
the
you
challenge to
read.
To him. Yeah. Bring me forth the two contradictions.
Yes, I heard.
I'm waiting for the. I'm waiting for your.
But I just told you.
What?
Go to the verse I mentioned and read it. Why are you to do that? Why are you opening the Quran? No, I don't have it there. All the references are there.
Yo, Pete,
not the actual.
Get both.
Listen.
Look, you said there's a contradiction.
Why don't
you can't get
go
up.
And read
he
it?
He said there's
I
a contradiction.
What
you
I just said.
Why can't you read them now?
I just gave it
read
to you. Read it. Look, why didn't you read
ask that verse?
Read
not
the way it says.
The scripture is not there. The references are there. The references are there.
Look,
speak English. I told you the references are there. Not the scripture. How many times should I repeat it to you?
Listen. Can you read the first part of the?
I just told you.
Read the second.
Oh man, this guy is a waste of time. I'm not gonna argue with you
anyway.
Because you get around circles.
Go away then.
Yeah. You can't call me stolen.
Go away then. If you don't want to talk, if you don't want to show
no,
me, if you don't want to show
you're not reasonable. What's the point of me speaking to you? You're just talking over me and not doing what you've been told.
There's no point.
I'm asking you to bring it up. The verse I read.
Let me say one thing.
You don't
want
to show
me.
I'm not scared to do it.
Read it. Read it.
You will. I will.
You do it.
Let me tell you.
Just read it.
All Muslim.
Run now.
Can I say something?
Can I say something?
You believe
you're
that Muhammad is the last prophet?
That verse for you.
Do you believe?
I'm saying to you, I've read that verse, and for me, there's no contradiction.
That don't make any sense.
It doesn't make any sense.
Let me tell you why. That's what I'm saying.
Why
do
you see a
this
contradiction?
Hold on. What you said.
Hold on.
Why you said. 1 second.
Let me finish.
Why you said.
No, let me finish.
You made a claim.
No, I haven't. I haven't finished my claim. I haven't finished. You said you read that verse, and there's a contradiction. You told us to read it. I've read that verse. I see no contradiction. So now it doesn't make sense.
You haven't read it.
That doesn't make sense.
It's up to you.
That don't make any sense.
The contradiction is.
It's same as saying. Can I give you an example? You said when I read it, it's a contradiction.
When you read it,
it's a contradiction.
So you
that
have to tell me where you think
saying, this country is you care for me. This country is USA for you.
It goes to show.
See all of us, yeah?
All of us, as if you say
we don't see
this is the UK.
Show
up
for you. Contradiction.
I said this is Mexico for me. Does that make sense?
No, it doesn't.
But that's what you said.
Listen,
wait. RHV, we didn't say this.
But that's what you're doing. That's what you're doing. You're saying that UK is Mexico.
Hold on.
Let me give you the contradiction.
That Jesus is the last prophet who is coming again.
Because Isaiah told us
when he is coming,
Huh?
What's the question?
When the Quran is
talking about Jesus. Do you know why I don't believe? Let me
Jesus
explain.
Jesus is coming.
Do you know why I don't believe?
Yeah.
Do you know why I don't believe?
Oh no, not at all.
I believe Jesus is coming again.
Yeah, we agree.
It's in the Bible. It's in the Bible.
We agree.
That's why.
Are you a Jew?
That's why.
Are you a children of Israel? Are you the children of Israel?
Oh?
Are you a children of Israel?
Yes, I am. Huh? I am. Yeah.
So what's wrong with it? I'm spiritually a child of Israel.
No.
Yeah. I'm spiritually a child of
Israel. So am I.
You are Gentile.
No, you
Gentile,
are not.
Gentile.
Spiritually, you can be, but I can't.
Let me tell you why. You are not.
You can be spiritually, but
I
can't.
Yes, I am.
You can.
Let me tell you why you are not. If you don't believe the atoning sacrifice of